Hello everyone, I hope you all are fit and healthy. So here I am Miss Pratiksha Singh conducting your second lecture on physics paper 1, that is mechanics and thermodynamics. So here in previous lecture of compound pendulum, we have been studied about introduction to compound pendulum and time period of oscillation of compound pendulum. And now in second lecture, we are going to study about reversible compound pendulum. So here we will see what is the example of reversible compound pendulum and what is the experimental procedure to conduct the experiment of compound pendulum. So here is a diagrammatic representation of compound pendulum. So what is meant by reversible compound pendulum? So reversible compound pendulum is a special design of a normal physical pendulum, and this type of pendulum is able to swing from either of two mounting points, means there are two fixed points and this compound is able to swing by using these two points. And this compound pendulum can be set up in such a way that the period of oscillation is same from both these points, means these two points gives us same period of oscillation while performing the experiment. Now what is the example of reversible compound pendulum? There is a special reversible compound pendulum which is called as Ketter's pendulum. This compound pendulum is invented by British physicist and army captain Henry Ketter in 1817. So the name of this compound pendulum is given as Ketter's pendulum in the honor of this scientist Henry Ketter. So what is the use of this compound pendulum, or we can say that Ketter's pendulum? So the use of this Ketter's pendulum, it is act as a gravimeter instrument to measure the local acceleration of gravity, means the value of g. Now you all know that the value of small g, that is acceleration due to gravity, is 9.8 meter per second square everywhere on the surface of earth. This value is constant, it does not change, okay? The value of g is 9.8 meter per second square. But sometimes this value changes this value shows some variations. Like if we go towards the pole of the earth, or if we go towards the equator of the earth, then the value of g changes slightly, means there is only point difference between the value. And if we go towards the depth of the or inside the earth, this value increases, the value of g increases from 9.8 to something like 9.85 or 9.9, okay? And if we go towards the height above the surface of earth, then this value decreases. Like if we go towards the mount, at the top of the Mount Everest, then their value is 9.77, means the value decreases from 9.8 to 9.77. Then if you go to the communication satellite, which is very much above from the surface of the earth, then their value, then at that place, at communication satellite, that place the value of g is something like 0.25 or something like 0.75, means in the range of 0. So that much value decreases if we go upward in direction of the above the surface of the earth. So the value changes in gravitational acceleration if we go above the surface of earth, or if we go down the or inside the earth. So what actually this value changes, and this value accurately will given by this Ketter's pendulum. So Henry Ketter designed a special compound pendulum. If we perform the experiment of this Ketter's pendulum, then we can able to calculate the actual or accurate value of g at that place. Okay, so we will see what actually the construction of this Ketter's pendulum and how the experimental procedure is to be performed, and afterward we will see how we can calculate the value of g using the formula of Ketter's compound pendulum. Okay, So see here, the basic principle on which the Ketter's reversible pendulum is based is the center of suspension and center of oscillation. Reversibility is there in center of suspension and center of oscillation. That's why this pendulum is called as reversible compound pendulum. Okay, so if you see in diagram, this is the picture of our Ketter's pendulum which is fixed in our college. So see what construction is there. So Ketter's reversible pendulum is consist of metal rod of uniform cross section. A heavy cylindrical weight W1 can be fixed near its one end so that the center of mass of the rod is shifted towards this end. There are two weights, that is W1 and W2. One weight is of metal or metallic cylinder and other weight is of wood. Okay, so we have been used two cylinders. If you see in picture, there are two cylinders and one cylinder is made up of metal and other cylinder is made up of wood. So the weight of that metallic cylinder is denoted as W1 and weight of the wooden cylinder is denoted as W2. Then there are two knife edges. If you see in picture, there are two black color knife edges who are denoted as K1 and K2. These are facing each other and may be adjusted near the edges. Okay, so this is all about construction of Ketter's reversible pendulum. It is made up of metallic rod of uniform cross section area and there are two heavy cylinders W1 and W2. One is made up of metallic cylinder and another is wooden cylinder. Then there are two knife edges K1 and K2 which are fixed at the end of this metallic rod. Then we will see what is the experimental setup and procedure of this experiment. So if you see in diagram, you are able to know how the these cylinders have been fixed in this metallic rod. So there is one metallic rod and at the center of this metallic rod, there is a wooden, or we can say there is a simple cylinder have been weighted as W is fixed at the center of this metallic rod. Then we have two knife edges K1 and K2 which have been fixed at the same distance or at the equal distance from this. Yes, two knife edges K1 and K2 have been adjusted or have been fixed at equal distance from central cylinder, that is W. Then we have two cylinders, one is made up of metal and another is made up of wooden. So these two cylinders are denoted as W1 and W2. They are also fixed at some equal distances from this knife edges. So this is all about construction. And if we go to the procedure, see step by step what is the actual procedure of this Ketter's reversible pendulum, how we can perform this experiment in our laboratory. So see, first step says shift the weight W1 to one end of Ketter's pendulum and fix it. Fix the knife edge K1 just below it. Yes, first of all we have to adjust this weight W1 at the top of this metallic rod. And after that we have to fix the knife edge K1. Then second step says keep the knife edge K2 at the another end and fix the wooden weight W2 symmetrical to the other end. So mind that the distance between the K2 and W and K1 and W, so this distance should be equal. And again, distance between K1 W1 and distance between K2 W2 should be equal. Okay, so likewise we have to adjust this knife edges and wooden and metallic cylinders. Then what we have to do, third step says suspend the pendulum about the knife edge 1. So we have to fix the pendulum at the knife edge K1. म्हणजे आपल्याला K1 हा जो knife edge आहे याला top ला ठेवून ह्या pendulum ला एका point ला fix करायचा आहे. We can fix it at wall or at any other surface. Okay, and we have to perform our experiment. Now what is we have to perform? We have to first of all suspend the pendulum about knife edge K1. K1 and take the time for about 10 oscillations. Yes, आपल्याला काय करायचं आहे की ह्या पेंडुलमला एक्स्ट्रीम पोझिशनला घेऊन गेल्यानंतर जस्ट वी हॅव टू गिव अ पुश. एक पुश दिल्यानंतर हा पेंडुलम ऑसिलेट करू लागेल. ओके, दिस पेंडुलम विल स्टार्ट ऑसिलेटिंग अँड वी हॅव टू स्टार्ट अवर स्टॉपवॉच ॲट दॅट टाईम व्हेअर वी विल स्टार्ट द ऑसिलेशन्स ऑफ पेंडुलम. ज्यावेळेस पेंडुलमचे ऑसिलेशन स्टार्ट करू त्यावेळेस आपल्याला स्टॉपवॉच चालू करायचं आहे फ्रॉम झिरो टायमिंग. ओके, आणि ऑसिलेशन्स कॅल्क्युलेट करायचे आहे. वी हॅव टू काउंट द ऑसिलेशन्स अप टू 10. जोपर्यंत 10 ऑसिलेशन्स कंप्लीट होत नाहीत तोपर्यंत स्टॉपवॉच चालू ठेवायचं आहे. ज्यावेळेस 10 ऑसिलेशन्स कंप्लीट होतील त्यावेळेस स्टॉपवॉच बंद करायचं आणि जे काही टाईम असेल ते टाईम नोट डाऊन करून ठेवायचं ॲज अ स्मॉल T1. ओके, सो फर्स्ट 10 ऑसिलेशन्स वी हॅव टू रेकॉर्ड ॲज अ टाईम T1. सो जो काय स्मॉल T1 हा टायमिंग आहे आपण रेकॉर्ड करून ठेवलेला आहे. त्याच्यानंतर कॅपिटल T1 कसं कॅल्क्युलेट करणार? जो स्मॉल T1 टायमिंग जो आहे, सपोज इट इज मे बी इन सेकंड्स, यू हॅव मेजर टाईम इन सेकंड्स, सो यू हॅव टू डिवाइड दॅट टाईम बाय 10. ओके, सपोज फॉर 10 ऑसिलेशन्स द टाईम टेकन ॲज 10 सेकंड्स, सो यू हॅव टू डिवाइड द 10 सेकंड्स बाय 10, यू विल गेट 1. सो दॅट 1 व्हॅल्यू इज द व्हॅल्यू ऑफ कॅपिटल T1. सो लाईकवाईज यू हॅव बीन फाउंड value of capital T1. So record the value of capital T1. Okay, so up to this has been done. What is the next? We have to revert this pendulum. Revert karayacha aahe pendulum la. Revert karane manje kay? Knife edge K1 na apan pendulum jo aahe to fix kela hota. Ata ha pendulum aplyala reverse karayacha aahe ani W2 ani K2 he je cylinders aahet yanna upward direction la fix karayacha. आणि W1 आणि K1 हे जे सिलेंडर्स आहेत यांना डाऊनवर्ड डायरेक्शनला फिक्स करायचं. ओके, नाव K2 अँड W2 आर ऑन अपर साईड अँड K1 अँड W1 आर ऑन डाऊनवर्ड साईड अँड अगेन फॉलो द सेम प्रोसिजर. अगेन काउंट 10 ऑसिलेशन्स अँड रेकॉर्ड द टाईम रिक्वायर टू कम्प्लीट 10 ऑसिलेशन. सो दॅट व्हॅल्यू विल बी द व्हॅल्यू ऑफ स्मॉल T2. ओके, जसं आपण स्मॉल T1 रेकॉर्ड केलं त्याचप्रमाणे आपल्याला स्मॉल T2 सुद्धा रेकॉर्ड करायचं आहे. आणि ही स्मॉल T2ची व्हॅल्यू जी आहे त्या व्हॅल्यूला सुद्धा 10 डिवाइड केल्यानंतर जी व्हॅल्यू आपल्याला मिळेल दॅट इज द व्हॅल्यू ऑफ कॅपिटल T2. सो लाईकवाईज वी हॅव बीन रेकॉर्डेड द व्हॅल्यू ऑफ कॅपिटल T1 अँड व्हॅल्यू ऑफ कॅपिटल T2. नाव माइंड दॅट द व्हॅल्यू ऑफ कॅपिटल T1 अँड द व्हॅल्यू ऑफ कॅपिटल T2 शुड नॉट बी इक्वल. या दोन्ही व्हॅल्यूज ज्या आहेत ते इक्वल नसल्या पाहिजेत. द व्हॅल्यू ऑफ कॅपिटल T1 अँड कॅपिटल T2 शुड नॉट बी इक्वल, बट द डिफरन्स बिटवीन दिस टाईम पिरियड, ओके, ह्या दोघांमधला जो डिफरन्स आहे दॅट शुड बी 0.01 सेकंड. ठीक आहे, आपण कॅल्क्युलेट केल्यानंतर T1 आणि T2मधला जो डिफरन्स आहे तो 0.01 सेकंद किंवा 0.01 सेकंदच्या आसपास असला पाहिजे. इट शुड बी नियर बाय 0.01 सेकंद. ओके, afterward we have to calculate the value of h1 and h2. These are the heights, or we can say the distance. So which distance? Distance between k1 and w is the value of h1. Okay, k1 and w cha madhe kiti distance ahe, that is the value of h1, and the distance between k2 and w is the value of h2. ओके, सो अशा प्रकारे आपण H1, H2 आणि T1 आणि T2 या चार व्हॅल्यूज ज्या आहेत त्या एक्सपेरिमेंटवरून रेकॉर्ड केलेल्या आहेत. नाव वी आर गोइंग टू कॅल्क्युलेट द व्हॅल्यू ऑफ जी, व्हॅल्यू ऑफ स्मॉल जी बाय युझिंग बेसल्स फॉर्म्युला. ओके, सो सी बेसल्स फॉर्म्युला. सो द फॉर्म्युला सेज जी इज इक्वल टू 8π² अपॉन T1² प्लस T2² डिवाइडेड बाय L1 प्लस L2 प्लस T1² माइनस T2² डिवाइडेड बाय L1 माइनस L2. सो दिस इज द फॉर्म्युला फॉर कॅल्क्युलेटिंग द व्हॅल्यू ऑफ जी. नाव व्हॉट द टर्म्स दिस फॉर्म्युला कंटेन्स? सो दिस फॉर्म्युला कंटेन्स द व्हॅल्यू ऑफ पाय. नाव यू ऑल नो द व्हॅल्यू ऑफ पाय इज कॉन्स्टंट, समटाईम इट इज 3.142 लाईकवाईज. ओके, अँड ऑल्सो द टर्म्स लाईक L1, L2, T1, T2 अँड G. So here I have taken L1 and L2 as a length that we have been seen as a H1 and H2. So sometimes the length or distance between K1 to W and K2 to W is the value of H1 and H2, or sometimes it is L1 and L2. You can use any terms. Okay. So distance between knife edges and W, so it is same value. So that distance is called as L1 and L2. These are two lengths, and time periods that we have been recorded as a capital T1 and capital T2. And G is acceleration due to gravity. So by using this experiment, we have recorded the values of L1, L2, T1 and T2. Okay, so these four values we have now, and we put this value into this formula, and by calculating this formula, we can get the value of G. So wherever we want the accurate value of gravitational acceleration, that time, in that place, we will perform this Ketter's compound pendulum experiment, and we can get accurate answer of, or we can say accurate value of gravitational acceleration. But note that the difference between time periods, that is T1 and T2, that must be 0.01 second. So this is very important. If the difference between T1 and T2 is larger, then your experiment is going to be wrong. Then by knowing the values of L1, L2, T1 and T2, one can easily calculate the value of G. Yes, so using Bessel's formula, anyone can easily calculate the value of G by using the Ketter's reversible pendulum. So I hope you have been understand how we can perform the reversible compound pendulum's experiment, and what is Ketter's reversible pendulum, what is the use of Ketter's reversible pendulum, what is construction, then procedure, and how we can calculate the value of G accurately by using Bessel's formula. So write down this topic in your notebook, revise it, and be ready for assignments. And I will come to next topic in another video. Till then, thank you and bye-bye.